Earn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 2369. Handwrite your cells with the action pen. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I just discovered this one. It's not even in the documentation yet. It's been in Word. It's been in PowerPoint. Brand new to Excel. There's a new pen on the Draw tab called an action pen. And it says you can use the action pen to enter data by handwriting. Let's try it out. So I click the action pen. We're put into draw mode. Down here in the lower right-hand corner, we're automatically set to 400%. And very carefully with the mouse, I will write 123. When I quit writing, they evaluate my handwriting and type 123. This would be really good, I guess, if you're on a tablet that didn't have a keyboard and you didn't want to use a little pop-up keyboard. It works fairly well. I'm impressed at their ability to recognize my handwriting. 890. Now the one thing that I find is kind of annoying about this is then I want to go select a cell, but I can't select a cell because I'm in drawing mode. You know, so if you click there and you get that dot, they'll just evaluate that as nothing, but you do select that cell. So you have to remember to get out of drawing mode if you would actually want to do something like Alt equals to put in a sum. Now a couple of cool tricks here in the action pen. If you want to select a few cells, just draw a circle around those cells and that will select those cells, and then you can use the mini toolbar to change the font color or something like that. You can also just overwrite things. So if that 123 needs to be 234, I guess first we have to select it. All right. Go back into drawing mode, and if I just write 234, it will overwrite that cell. Cool, that works great. You can also get rid of a cell by crossing it out. And this is one that actually took a long time for me to get the hang of it. If you don't cross out the whole cell, then it's gonna interpret that as a minus sign. You get a minus sign. But if you do cross out all of the words in the cell like that, then it will simply press delete. And if you wanna get rid of one word, like long, that is not supported yet. You get the minus sign. Does it work with text? Yes, indeed. All right, so next time you find your keyboard broken or you're stuck on a tablet computer and you don't want to use a little on-screen pop-up keyboard, cool way to go. The team that does this drawing for all of Office, for PowerPoint, Word, and Excel has been doing some nice improvements. They've added some new pen colors here, and even like gel pens with Galaxy, things like that. And in general, with ink, you're just scribbling, right? You're creating little scribbles. But one cool feature that they have here is if you would choose ink to shape, and it doesn't work retroactively. You have to choose ink to shape first, and then draw a square. They will convert that to a square, or a circle, a triangle, even like an oval, and maybe a parallelogram. Right, so that's been around for a while. Ink to math, I'm not a fan of this. I have an old video that shows this. It just creates an equation that you can't do anything with. Some tools, I guess PowerPoint, now have the ability under the eraser to do a point eraser, which would allow you to erase just one bit of the drawing. Right now, that is not working in Excel. You touch anywhere in the drawing and the whole drawing disappears. This will be nice when this comes to Excel. Now, hey, if you don't have the draw toolbar, it's really easy. Just right click up here, customize the ribbon, and over on the right hand side, this will be unchecked. You check it, click OK. It's Labor Day in the United States, but I saw that new tool and I wanted to make sure that you knew it first. Click like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.